Hello everyone, and welcome to our continuation of our endeavour to find a lease or a purchase horse. Today we're at a little barn that doesn't actually have an official name, but it's right by Dewberry Creek and is actually south of Emerald Ranch. I got into contact with some friends and Scully told me that Flickers is actually working there. Flickers you might have seen on the massive trail ride, and she was also one of the staff members on the endurance ride as well. She informed me the barn had a couple horses we could try, and so we set off. We ended up getting there far later than I wanted to because of a parade happening in Valentine that ended up blocking the roads, but when we did get there, Flickers was an absolute doll and had already tacked up the horses. Queasy did her usual thing of wandering off and going to go pet horses and look at ones she liked. I went straight over to Flickers, however, who was grooming the beautiful Alexandros, whose barn name was actually Alex. He was actually a draft warm blood mix. They didn't actually have too much information on his exact breed, but he is so pretty. He's actually in the older range than what I was looking at. He was about 15 years old. And because I was looking for more of a competition horse that would really push my riding, at first I wasn't that interested in him, but never judge a book by its cover. Me and Flickers had a quick discussion about him, and it turns out that he is mostly used as a work slash trail horse. He's super chill, super reliable, and he even gets leased out to Emerald when they need extra horses for their bigger trail rides. I'm going to be honest here, at this point I had kind of already ruled Alex out just because he was a little bit too old and he didn't fit the criteria that I wanted, which was for my riding to kind of be pushed by a little bit more of an experience but also a horse with a good prospect. However, I won't deny that Alex is an absolutely gorgeous horse. He's a tri-coloured. I actually do have a massive soft spot for paint or painted horses. His tail was actually braided, Flickers told me, because he was due to go on a couple trail rides and his hair is quite long and thick, so they have to braid it every time. I wish I could have seen it down, but that's completely fine. When I did decide to mount up, normally I would do some more bonding with the horse just so that it kind of knows me a little bit more. He did check me out here with his ears, but then as soon as we started going, he wasn't fussed about me at all. He was just kind of listening to the world around him. He was a tiny bit on the lazy side, dragging his feet a little bit, but as soon as I kind of gave him a bit of a squeeze, he completely listened and he moved forward a bit more. And I have to admit, from a GoPro perspective, this horse is so pretty. Like, his head is just beautiful. His colors really come out nicely in the video, I suppose. I could also tell that he was really balanced. That was clearly coming off of years and years of doing trail rides. And the Emerald trail rides can get really experienced as well, where they're going up into the Grizzlies and sometimes into Coulter with the snow, and they need horses that are really strong as well as sure-footed. Now, I did kind of whisper to Queasy here that he's too old. Flickers didn't hear it, but I just kind of wanted to let Queasy know that he wasn't exactly what I was looking for. However, as time kind of went on, the more I kind of settled into Alex and I was kind of listening more to him, he was just so tranquil in a way. He was listening to the world around him, but he didn't feel like he was gonna get spooked by anything. I did push him here into more of a trot, and again, he was a tiny bit on the lazy side. He wasn't really picking up his feet much, so I kind of was joking about that too Queasy, but eventually I did get him to push forward a little bit more. This was at the point I realized the girth was too loose, which I should have checked beforehand, so that's on me. But luckily, Queasy said she sought it for me since she was standing right by. And even though the girth was getting tightened, and I know quite a lot of horses can get really kind of disheveled by this, they don't like it being done, he did shake his head a couple times, but he didn't seem too fussed at all, which again was a plus point for him. I just said to Flickers that everything was still cool. Honestly, I was really interested to kind of try him at a canter as well, just to see how his rhythm was, because a lot of the trail horses are really experienced in the walking trotting area, but sometimes can come off a little bit stiff on the canter. Now, I did go ahead and change Leeds to the left side to try him out there first, because that's my weaker side, just to see how that goes. When I did kick him in, he did that kind of jog thing run rather than going straight into the canter, which is a bit more of a young, untrained horse kind of thing, but I wasn't too bothered about that. That could have just been my signals not being clear enough. But as we were going around, it kind of shocked me a little bit because I expected his strides to be a lot longer, and they really weren't. They were quite short, actually. That threw me off balance a tiny, tiny bit, so I decided to take him out of the canter, go back into a trot, just kind of rebalance myself. But again, as a horse, he was very, very intuitive. He was listening to me really, really well. I never at any point felt unsafe. I was quickly talking to Queasy about it because I was laughing because she could see that I was kind of off balance. So I did ask her if she wanted to have a little go on Alex before we put him away. And she wasn't too keen. Older horses, and especially draft horses, aren't really her thing. But I pretty much convinced her to do it because I wanted some nice shots of him moving as well. Because at the time, Queasy didn't have a camera on her, so the filming would be down to my GoPro. I was a tiny bit disappointed here. As you can see, before Queasy's completely settled in the saddle, he started moving. I'm not entirely sure why he did this. It could have been Queasy, it could have been him not listening, I'm not entirely sure, but that is something to note. However, seeing him from the ground, he looks like a genuinely magnificent horse. I don't know, again, his exact breeding, but he's definitely got the strength of a draft, but he's also got a little bit of sportiness in him. He's clearly really well ridden. He's just a beautiful boy all in all. I was interested to see his gaits from the ground because, as you guys saw from the footage, he was pretty smooth to ride. Looking at him, it looked a little bit strange because I expected his stride to be a lot longer. He is kind of taking shorter steps than I thought he would. Here Queasy is just changing the direction because she wanted to push him into a canter so that I could see. His canter transition wasn't the prettiest, but it got the job done. It's really interesting because as a horse, he looks quite heavy, but when you're actually riding him, he doesn't at all feel heavy on the reins or even in terms of his turning. He is a tiny, tiny bit on the lazy side. He doesn't stretch out as much as I kind of wish he would. However, he is super, super balanced, and you can tell that there's real power behind his strides. Being honest, I did develop a little bit of a soft spot for Alex because it was such a contrast going from riding Jericho, who is a horse who is constantly trying to figure out where in the herd he kind of stands. He's always trying to push ahead of people. He's trying to one-up me. He's trying to constantly kind of find his place in the world, and he's not too sure of himself, to Alex, who is a horse who... it feels like he has a very open heart. He's never trying to challenge anyone. He's just doing his thing. And I really, really loved that about him. I was chatting to Queasy while she was riding, and she was nothing but compliments for him. Now, don't get me wrong, this isn't the kind of horse Queasy is into, but she did say honestly that he would suit me. And that was a little bit difficult to hear because he didn't suit any of the criteria, but I did feel kind of a love towards him. Honestly, I think this is the worst part of having to look for a horse to buy, is you will kind of connect with horses that are either out of your budget or just not what you're looking for. And a part of me just wanted him, just to take him. However, I was aware of the fact that he may not be exactly suited to the life that I was looking to give him. We chatted a bit more about him, and honestly, I was really, really on the fence. So I'm actually going to still put him in my maybe section, just because why the heck not? We would have to watch out for Emerald Ranch looking to purchase him if they thought that we were going to take him away, since they do lease him from time to time for their trail rides, and he's a very experienced horse. But in terms of budget, he was definitely on the slightly lower end due to his age. And I felt a little bit bad because I think he would be far more suited to a greener rider, a rider looking to just really get into horse riding, rather than a rider looking for more experience in the kind of professional area. Anyway, it was a good job. I didn't have to make a decision there and then since the owners weren't in. Anyway, we actually decided to go ahead and have lunch around here. We had a lovely little picnic down the way. I didn't film any of it though because we were talking about some quite personal stuff. But I love these girls so, so much and I had such a lovely time. However, after our lunch break, we did get to see the show horse. I may have been giving Alex some hugs, but that's not important. Here was the show horse. I was not expecting him to be an Overo, but he is gorgeous. I was super excited for Queasy to try this horse, and I think she was quite interested in him as well. He was 6 years old, he was new in the showing ring, and I think I'm going to leave a montage here to show how awesome he looks. Absolutely brilliant. He did super, super well. Even from the ground, I could tell he was incredibly well trained and he would be an absolute showstopper in the ring. However, that's kind of the reason Queasy told me later she wasn't super interested in him, because she was looking for a horse that was more rough around the edges a little bit, rather than one that was more polished like he was. But before we left, I did actually manage to bag us a hack on the two horses that we tried that day. Since we were already quite comfortable on the horses about their training, we thought it was perfectly fine to go out on a tiny little trail ride around the area. It did give us more time to have a little bit of a gossip with Flickers and catch up with her. I'm going to leave this again to the montage to show. Thank you. one of our shorter hacks, but it was one of the most enjoyable. It did have a little bit of rain, but again, this just fortified my thoughts that Alex is a very, very reliable horse. He actually did have some speed in him when we were doing the cantering, which took me a bit by surprise, but it just shows me he still has that spark of youthfulness in him. What do you guys think about a match with me and Alex? Do you think that we'd be a good pair? And do you think I should consider buying him, or if I should keep looking? I'm going to keep on the horse hunt for now, but I'd really like to hear your opinions. And what do you think about Queasy and the show horse? She's already told me she's not really interested in buying him, but I thought they made a pretty good pair. I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Huge thanks to Flickers for helping out and letting us try the horses. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Stay positive, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.